I'm not finished with you!
How you doing?
That's Alex every day, every day, every day.
How you doing?
That's Alex every day.
Championship match, you do not even have to defeat Roman Reigns.
Wait. Don't you worry, I'll beat Roman Reigns, just like I have every time we've stepped into the ring against one another. In fact, what you and the rest of the world need to realize is that I own Roman Reigns. I've mentally broken Roman Reigns. I've exposed Roman Reigns. It wasn't too long ago, Roman was calling himself a fighting champion, and all three members of the Shield, oh yes, they were all going to be great champions together. And because of me, the Shield will never be champions together. Because of me, Dean Ambrose is now a stay-at-home husband living off his wife's paycheck. And because of me, Roman Reigns has become the type of champion who gets himself disqualified to preserve his title. And thanks to me, tonight he does not have that option. In fact, Roman Reigns has run out of options. He's run out of friends, and he's run out of time. Because when I put him to sleep and I become the new Intercontinental Champion, he will understand that it may be his yard, but he lives in my world. In fact, you've put being champion even in front of being a member of your own family. Which I find kind of funny, because last week, AJ, you came out here and you told me a marvelous, lovely tale about how now you can stare your lovely daughter in her eyes and you can say, you can be anything you put your mind to. But AJ, I've known you a long, long time, and I know the truth. And the fact is, you're barely home long enough to hug your child, let alone look at her lovingly in her eye. No, but it's part of the sacrifice, you see. You see, AJ Styles, the truth is, in your heart, you know, you feel much more comfortable being on the road and living out of a suitcase than you ever have being a husband to your wife. It's the sacrifice, AJ. I understand. I get it. Because you see, AJ Styles, you, my friend, you have put being a champion above all else, even if it means you're a failure as a father. Yeah, it hurts, I know. But AJ, don't worry, because for all your sacrifice, for the fact that you work your fingers to the bone, the fact that you train like an animal to be WWE champion, I am coming soon and I will take it all from you. Because the truth is, AJ, come SummerSlam, when the whole world is cheering you on to victory, secretly, AJ, your family, in their realest of feelings, they'll be cheering for me. Because after I'm done tearing down your house, after I'm done putting you to sleep, oh, your wife and kids, they'll have their daddy back. But I will be WWE champion.
Reality is, I kicked your ass last night. That's the reality.
Oh, don't worry about that. Because sooner than later, I'm putting your ass to sleep. Hey, you know in your heart of hearts, if you're really honest with yourself, you didn't beat me last night. You escaped me.
Oh, yes, I did. This is for real, Jim.
Hey, and you've never beaten me.
Hey, excuse me, and excuse me. Let's just get one thing straight. From my opinion, and my opinion does matter around here, the big dog that put the under Samoan trophy case? That's a claim for a title opportunity. The excommunicated Samoan thrown out of his own tribe that took an F5. You'll never see Brock Lesnar in a title match again. Mark my words, never. You're done. You're finished.
You see that? You see that? That's your advocate. That's the man who knows you better than anyone. Hey, you need to listen to your advocate. He's protecting you from me. Because in his heart, deep down, at the bottom of his soul, he knows I'm the one. I'm the man. Hey, you look at me when I'm talking to you, or we can straighten this out right now. He's the man that knows I got your number.
Boy, you're about to piss me right
off. Hold up, you got his number?
All right, hold on, guys.
You showed the whole world that last night, right?
All right, listen up. That's enough. That's enough. This is what we're going to do.
Wait. Hey, you're real mouthy for a man who got beat down by Braun Strowman last night. For over a year, you've been coming out here week after week saying that you were the only one who could beat Brock Lesnar. And the reality is, no matter how many whispers you heard, no matter how many eyes couldn't meet you, you failed. And that makes you a failure. And you know what else it makes you, Roman? It makes you a liar. You lied to these fans. You lied to your family, you lied to yourself. In fact, you're still lying because you can't face the facts that every time Roman Reigns and Brock Lesnar get in a ring together, you get jacked up. You get put through tables. You get carted out on a stretcher. You get broken and Brock Lesnar gets richer. And no matter how many times we tell this story, trust me, it's gonna be the same thing. When the big dog meets the beast conquers you, and you come out here making excuses why it happened. But I bear good tidings and good news that the vicious cycle will end. Because after Brock Lesnar is done ragdolling you across that cage and you fail once again, I'll be waiting at Backlash to put you to sleep. And by the lack of a champion in the building, it seems that the Styles family has started to take my threats seriously. Now I know, last week on SmackDown, I said that I just might stop by the house and pay a visit. In fact, I know that somewhere in the backwoods of Gainesville, Georgia, the Styles clan is all huddled around in the living room. Wendy, I know you're cradling young Annie in her arms, who's probably scared and trembling at all the horrible things that you've told about her Uncle Joe and what he does. But most importantly, Wendy, here's what I need you to look at. In that same room is your hubby, standing there, staring at the door, curtains drawn, locked up tight, probably with a baseball bat, wondering just when I'm gonna bust through that door. But he's got an ear open because he's a smart man. Maybe I'll come through the back. But that's not gonna happen because, Wendy, I am not a monster. Wendy, I'm not the man that you think I am. I only said what I said last week because I'm keeping my promise to you. I need you to look in that room and see what I've done for you, Wendy. I have delivered your absentee husband on a coveted Tuesday night back home with his family. But more than that, Wendy, My actions have forced him to actually care about you. My actions have forced him to come home and actually look after his family. I have kept my promise to you, Wendy. And I want the Styles Clan to enjoy tonight. Young Annie, I want you to enjoy Daddy tucking you in and making you feel safe. Because from now on, there's gonna be a lot more nights just like that. Because Annie, at Hell in a Cell, a very, very bad man is coming to take your daddy's championship, and then he's gonna make him go night night. Hey Wendy, I made you a promise. Daddy was coming home. It looks like he's not, but I'll be your new daddy.
Look, wait, look at that. And show it. Oh my God, it's Samoa Joe.
Somebody's got to get out here and get this under control.
Oh, Wendy! It seems like we're making a lot of promises tonight, including one to come home and tuck in the kids. But guess what? Daddy's already done night-night. Oh, AJ. AJ, I'm not gonna come out there tonight. I mean, look at you. You're proving my point. You're out here acting like superhero to the world. But who's there for your kids to look up to right now? You know what? Maybe I'm not done playing daddy yet. Maybe it's just too much fun. Hello, Wendy. No. You know who this is. You know this is. And how is our little Annie? All right. Easy. Wendy, listen to me. I know why you're angry. I would be too. But listen, I'm gonna keep the promise that AJ never did. And I'm gonna send him home. Don't worry. And by the way, are we still on for the back-to-school barbecue next week? Wendy, listen, save me a plate. Maybe I'll stop by next Tuesday. Hey, congratulations. 20 years, Jeff. That is a very, very long time. And please forgive my tardiness. I was in the back. I was popping some bottles. I was getting ready to come out here and have a toast. But I think we can all agree maybe having a bottle of champagne around you isn't the best idea.
I can't tell the truth.
No, Shane, it's cool. Shane, please let him through. Joe, talk. What do you want to say, man? Please. Let him through.
Hey. And thank you to WWE for that wonderful video package, that wonderful anthology of all your greatest moments. It must have been a special treat for you, considering at the time you probably weren't coherent enough to remember any of it anyways.
Jeff.
I mean, this is too far.
Jeff. What? Hey, Jeff, up here. Hey, man, I'm at the bar. Well, of course, you know I'm at the bar. Hey, listen, man, I got eyes on it. You're doing great. You're having a hell of a match, man. Keep it up. Gentlemen, one more round?
Yeah, that's what I like.
What the hell? Oh! RKO!
Samoa Joe.
Tough break, Jeff. Tough break. Hello. I'm WWE Superstar Samoa Joe, here to warn you about the dangers of excess. You see, there can be too much of a good thing. And like in most things in life, moderation is key. Now, you see, you can make some really good choices. You can choose to have a couple of these, go out with your friends, enjoy yourself, maybe even call it a night. Or you can choose to have 14 of these and wake up in jail. That is, if you're fortunate enough to wake up at all. The choice is clear. Drink responsibly.